Hi. Here we are in Agrigento, Sicily, in front of one of the best remaining Greek temples in the world. And it's a good place to talk about what is a Greek temple. Well, first of all, a temple is the home of the goddess or the god, or one of the homes. It's a place designed to attract that goddess or god to come to our city, inhabit this building, and bring her blessings upon us. And therefore, it's a place you're not invited inside of. All public ceremonies happen outside. But why this particular shape? Well, there are many theories, one of which is that this is an idealized sacred grove. We're all familiar with a sacred grove, a copse of trees, a place in the woods where a rivulet runs through, a babbling brook, perhaps a fawn disappears behind a bush, a place that seems sacred to us. And if you take the idea of a sacred grove of trees and regularize it, because if the goddess or gods of Olympia, Mount Olympus, that is, are going to live here, it's got to be perfect. So you take a grove of trees and you perfect it. Imagine those are the trunks of trees. Imagine that you regularized it in a mathematical way, because the gods speak in mathematics. The idealized world of nature is a world that speaks the language of mathematics. So you've got a regularized, idealized grove of trees. And it's mathematically perfect. Except it's not really mathematically perfect. Because if it was, it would look wrong to the eye. So the Greeks have taken what mathematics does with a building and made some changes that suit the eye, the sense of beauty. For one, look at the base. The base looks horizontal. It's not horizontal. If it were horizontal, the whole building would appear to sag. So the base bows up in the middle, both on the short axis and also on the long axis. Also, the columns appear to be vertical. If they really were vertical, the mass of the superstructure would make the columns appear to splay out. So the columns really are leaning inward. You can't see that. You have to do a plumb bob to tell it. But the fact that the columns are leaning inwards makes them look vertical. The base, the fact that it bows up, makes it look horizontal. The columns look like they're a straight taper, where it's clearly wider at the bottom, narrower at the top. But it's not a straight taper. If it were a straight taper, the columns would appear to be concave halfway up or two-thirds up. Instead, the columns bow out two-thirds up. So to make it look like a straight taper, it has to be not a straight taper. It has to be bowed. That's called entasis. The dimensions of the temple, they've tried many, many different combinations of the number of columns on the short side and on the long side. And finally, by the mid-5th century, by the mid-400s BCE, they decided on 6 and 13. And the formula for that is 2n plus 1. 6 is n. 6 times 2 is 12, plus 1 is 13. So 6 across the front, 13 on the long axis. And this became their standardized dimension for what they thought was the perfect dimensions of a Greek temple.